the Oakwood killing was not about tennis shoes. Okay? There's all kinds of urban myths out there about what was the motive in that murder. The victim ripped the perpetrator off for $500. The perp happened to be there and see him, was carrying a gun, and decided to shoot the killer. End of the story. The police response, I have to say, not patting ourselves on the back, was, I think, incredibly fast, ordered. We had assistance from the Gretna Police Department. We had assistance from State Police. And the Oakwood security folks did a hell of a job in managing mayhem in the immediate aftermath of that shots being fired. It could have gone much worse, I promise you. I think there were five caps fired at the individual, 40 caliber. But that was a personal beef. They knew one another. You know, as it relates to that, it just by happenstance that it occurred, you know, right there in Oakwood Shopping Center. And unfortunately, you know, it hit the national news and everything else. And, you know, we're going to be in a position probably within the next few days to start releasing more information about the details of that homicide. We also had the homicide over here at Deerfield and Esplanade. Charlie Gums, or Charles Gums, he's a notorious doper. He had about 3 dozen bags of marijuana on him at the time of the killing. He didn't get killed. He got shot 5 times and he lived. His girlfriend in the back seat died. They ended up driving over to the Brothers Food Mart, and that's where we found them. That is going to be, yet again, another personal beef between two dopers. It really had nothing to do with the house. That happened to be the victim's dad's home. I think the housing authorities here, and they had some issues and took some remedial action as it relates to that particular place, which was appropriate. And, but there's only so many things that you can control about the whereabouts of certain folks if they're not well-intentioned or well-intentioned either way.